record.
Yeah, me too.
I got that final prediction in plenty of time.
I'm kidding, man.
Yeah, Luca, we saw you and Dirk on the court after the game. He's been where you guys are going now. What kind of sentiments did he share with you?
Oh, he was just happy, man. I think it gave us, everybody in this team, a lot of confidence. When you see Dirk sitting courtside and away game, so I think everybody really appreciate him, because you know Dirk is Dirk. He's been through everything. He's been a champion, so he knows it. So I think every player and every coach is appreciate that he's there.
And you've been telling us for 4 years it's all about winning for you, and you know, now you guys have gotten to the conference finals. What does this mean to you personally and for the franchise?
Honestly, I'm really happy, man. You can't get this smile off my face right now. I'm just really happy, you know. Honestly, I think we deserve this. We've been playing hard the whole series, maybe a couple games here. We weren't ourselves, but, you know, we came here with a statement, game seven. We believed, our locker room believed, everybody believed, so I'm just happy.
Luca, you've told us and we've seen how much you enjoy playing, you know, whether you want to call it pressure situations, high-stakes situations. You're lighting the world on fire in the first half there. You're laughing after some of your baskets. How much fun were you having?
I'm having fun, man. I always say when I'm having fun is the way I best play. So I was having fun, man. But it wasn't me, man. It's not on me. It's the whole team today. Today was just incredible. I never seen a performance on game seven like this. I can't remember when was the the last time somebody went to the away game and did this. So I'm really proud of what we did today.
Were you aware at halftime you had as many points as the Suns?
Yeah, of course.
I mean, what do you?
I see it.
What do you think of that?
I think our defense was amazing. You know, but I mean, yeah, that was good. But like I said, you know, this is a team win, team effort. Everybody played amazing. Everybody just left everything on the court. So I'm really proud of this team.
Luka, considering the way that your defense was able to shut down Booker and Paul both in this game and at different times throughout the series, there aren't very many guys who can do what they do offensively. So what is then the ceiling for this team, and what at this point going forward? I mean, if y'all can do that to the Suns, what does that mean for anybody else that's left on your schedule?
I mean, I always said this team is special. The way we bond together, the way we play. When we play hard and defensively, it's tough to stop us. But I think after first two games here, our defense improved really well, and that's what won us the game.
You seemed really calm when you came out. You hit your first three shots. It was almost like you were playing in a scrimmage. How did you feel? You know, did it feel like a game seven to you?
Yeah, of course. I mean, it's game seven. You know, I like these games. It's pressure. You know, I think I know we were the underdogs. Everybody had the Suns on to win this one. But like I say, you know, the whole locker room believed. And that's what won us the game. And I think we play amazing today.
When nobody picks you to win this game and this series and all that, how does that make you guys feel overall, particularly when you're going to win it all game seven?
For me, it's same like trash talking. It gets me going. It's another motivational stuff. It gets us going. And everybody was talking about it even before the game won. You know, nobody picked us. So it was motivational for us.
Just tell us about the lift you guys got from Dinwiddie tonight with his 30 points.
Oh, amazing, man. The only thing I told him is don't go left because you're shooting air ball, so you got to go right.
Along those lines, with those 5 minutes or 6 minutes at the start of the second quarter when you're not on the court, how big was that? They turned a 10-point lead into whatever, 18.
Big, man. Like I say, you know, we have great players, so everybody can turn it on at some point. But like I said, you know, this was a great win. I can stop repeating that, my bad. But he was amazing today, and he was amazing other guys too. But just like the whole team played really, really well today.
Was Suns in four your rallying cry or just Theo's?
I mean, first it was Suns in four, then it was, I remember the next game what it was, but, you know, yeah, this, so. But like I said, you know, we believe, we're going to believe till the end, so that was it.
What's the biggest difference between this team now and the one last year that exited after the first round?
I mean, I think they asked me this before the game, so I said, you know, I think we learned a lot from the game 7 last year and game 6 when we lost. We had two chances to move on, but we didn't, you know. So I think we learned a lot from there, and this team is just special. I have nothing else to say.
You said a few times now, like, you guys believed. You guys believed that you could win this series. Was that hard in, you know, all the way back in December when you guys were struggling and you weren't playing up to your standards, or did you have any doubts?
What do you mean, like, doubts? Doubts about what?
Like, about how far you guys could go. Could you imagine being in the conference finals back in December when you guys didn't look, you know, looked so far away from it?
That's tough. I don't think I really was thinking about playoffs yet. But, you know, since that December, you know, we had a lot of problems. We had injuries. I say you got to go right, not left.
All right, we got two in Spanish real quick. Dinwiddie's waiting on Zoom.
Thank you.
Luca, Pedro Silva, Univision Dallas. Bueno, felicidades, que el equipo avanza a la final de conferencia. Aquí en el American Airlines, cada cesta, cada ventaja, los aficionados lo estaban celebrando, obviamente, con mucha euforia. ¿Qué se siente, no, para ustedes el darle esta alegría que desde el 2011 no se conseguía aquí en Dallas? Y también figuras como Tony Kroos del Real Madrid, Patrick Mahomes también de los Chiefs, comentando sobre tu actuación. ¿Qué dices al respecto?
Ha sido increíble. Yo sé que estaban en Dallas celebrándolo. Nos están apoyando cada rato, así que muchas gracias a todos. Y bueno, sobre todo Tony y Patrick. Patrick estuvo en algunos partidos aquí. Y ojalá cuando Tony gane las Champions, pues estará aquí también.
Okay, and last one, Eric.
¿Qué tal, Luca? ¿Cómo está Eric Mora de Telemundo Dallas? Cuéntanos cómo se vivió esta victoria. ¿Qué fue diferente tanto dentro del equipo de los Mavericks para ganar este partido de la manera en cómo se ganó? Y si nos puedes transportar, ¿qué se vivía en la arena? ¿Qué platicaban entre ustedes? ¿Cómo era ese ambiente en esta victoria?
Es un momento especial, ¿no? Porque nosotros creo que todos pensaban que íbamos a perder y nosotros, por eso nos motiva. Así que es un equipo increíble y creo que nos merecíamos nuestra victoria. Thank you.